Now that we've learned how to think about the polar coordinate system and plotting points in polar coordinates, we're going to transition to talking about plotting curves in the polar coordinate system. But we're going to start by thinking about some very basic equations, the most basic possible equations we could think of in polar coordinates. Let's start by thinking of equations of the form r equals a. So, for example, r equals 3. So what does this equation mean in polar coordinates? Well, if we consider the specific example r equals 3, this is the set of all points whose distance from the origin is 3. So what does that sound like? Well, a set of points some equal distance from the origin sounds like a circle. So going back to thinking just about the general equation r equals a, this is a circle with radius absolute value of a centered at the origin. But let me give you one other way to think about this. We know from before that one of the equations we can use to convert between polar and Cartesian coordinates is r squared equals x squared plus y squared. But in our case here, we're examining this equation r equals a. So if I just substitute that in here, I'm going to have a squared equals x squared plus y squared. And this, once again, is the equation of a circle of radius a, just written in the more familiar Cartesian format. So let's think about another kind of basic equation in polar coordinates. What if we have something of the form theta equals theta naught? So here, theta naught just represents a number. So I could give you the example, perhaps theta equals pi over 4. So what does this equation mean, or what would this look like on a graph? Well, this notation, if we consider the specific example theta equals pi over 4, means all the points that are an angle of pi over 4 from the polar axis. Now, since r is unspecified here, r could be either positive or negative, so then what we end up with is just a straight line that passes through the origin. So in general, the polar equation theta equals theta naught is a line through the origin that makes an angle of theta naught with a positive x-axis. And just like we did when we thought about our circle, let's try to relate this back to our Cartesian coordinate system. So we want to start by recalling the relationship that tangent of theta equals y over x. Once again, this is one of the ways we convert between polar and Cartesian coordinates. So in my specific case, then, I can say that tangent of theta naught equals y over x. Now, we're going to start by considering the case that theta naught is not equal to pi over 2 plus k pi, because these are the points where the tangent is undefined. So if I just do a little bit of rearranging of my equation up here, I can write this as y equals tangent of theta naught times x. Now this is an equation in y equals mx plus b form, and our slope is the tangent of theta naught. And then our y-intercept is 0, so once again we have a line that goes to the origin, and it has slope tangent of theta naught. Now in the case that theta naught does equal pi over 2 plus k pi, we know that the tangent of that angle is undefined, which means this denominator, x, is going to be 0. So in this case, then, we're going to just have x equals 0, which would be a vertical line through the origin. Now, one other case you could possibly see in regards to this line, theta equals theta 0, is the case in which we have theta equals theta 0, but we're restricting ourselves to r values greater than or equal to 0. And in that case, things are going to be very similar, but you're only going to have the one side of this line for which the r values are positive. Now, just like we were able to take points and convert between the polar coordinate system and the Cartesian coordinate system, we can also do a similar thing with polar equations. So let's actually look at a specific example. Let's say I have the polar equation r equals 10 cosine of theta. And let's say that we'd like to know what this polar equation looks like, but the way we're going to do that in this case is we're going to actually convert this to Cartesian equation, and then we'll graph that. So how are we going to convert this? Well, we just have to be a little clever. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to actually multiply both sides of this expression by r. And this might seem a little strange, but remember that we know some relationships that involve r squared, so perhaps it'll be helpful for us. Now, if we go through with this, we end up with r squared equals 10r cosine of theta. Now, remember, we know this conversion formula that r squared equals x squared plus y squared. And I have an r squared here on the left-hand side, so let's try making a substitution. And we'll say x squared plus y squared on the left. Now look on the right, and notice this factor r cosine of theta. Remember that we also know another formula that tells us that x equals r cosine of theta when we're converting between polar and Cartesian coordinates. So now I can write then on the right-hand side that this equals 10x. Okay, this is good. I have everything in terms of x and y now, but I don't really quite recognize what this is. So let's try to work with this a little bit and get it in a form that we're more familiar with. So I'm going to start by moving everything to one side of the equal sign, and we'll write this as x squared minus 10x plus y squared equals 0. And now I'm actually going to complete the square for my x terms here. Okay, so remember when I complete the square, let's actually set this off with some parentheses here. I'm going to add some special term. But then, in order to not actually change the equation, I'm going to then subtract that same value. And the way I get that value is I look at this coefficient of the x term, which here is negative 10, and I divide that by 2 and square the result. So here that's going to give me negative 5 squared, or 25. So now for a little bit of rearranging. I've got x squared minus 10x plus 25. Minus a 25 plus y squared equals 0. Now the whole point of completing the square is to get an expression like the one I have in parentheses that I can factor as a perfect square. So this factors into x minus 5 quantity squared, and if I move things around again, I can write this as plus y squared equals 25. Now hopefully you recognize this. This is the equation of a circle in Cartesian coordinate. And specifically, it's a circle centered at the point 5, 0 with a radius of 5. So this circle that I've drawn here. So the equation of the circle then in polar coordinates was r equals 10 cosine of theta. And in fact, we can make some generalizations. We already know from before that the equation r equals a describes a circle of radius absolute value of a centered at the origin. But using the same sort of argument that I used up here to show you this graph, we can also say that the equation r equals 2a sine of theta describes a circle of radius absolute value of a centered at the point 0a, and also the equation r equals 2a cosine of theta describes a circle of radius absolute value of a centered at the point a0.